Yeah, this is my vision, written without second thought or revision. The type of shit that affects you like an oncoming collision. That just make you freeze, drop to your knees and beg them please, Lord forgive me for gripping the semi now. When searching for God, all I ever do is stare at what Satan sending me, women wearing nothing but.
See, one thing a lot of people always ask me, where's the hot beats? In which over time, man, I've been trying to develop a list of producers in which I know people would fuck with that I approve of. You can see this list at downloadpaz.com/beats. But one producer in particular, his name is T Customs. We decided to collaborate to bring you guys quality production at the cheapest price possible. You can use my promo code, DownloadPazSave40, at tcustoms.com to save 40% on your next purchase. Definitely go to tcustoms.com, man, to peep out some good soulful styled beats and multiple other types of styles. What up, YouTube? This your boy Download back for another reply. But before then, let's talk about something that's going on in the music industry, man. So Jay-Z is getting his own Hublot collection. And what you don't know what Hublot is? Very expensive watch. Big face joints. His collection is going to be from $18,000 to $34,000. And I gotta say, Jay-Z, man, he just continues to innovate, man. You gotta take your hat off to him. But anyway, on to today's reply. Today's reply said, I walk a flocker from roaches to rolling. Now, to begin off with, man, let's get it fucking straight. You do not come to Waka Flocka to hear good fucking lyrics, man. That's not what he does. And honestly, as you listen to the mixtape, really, there's only one song on there that really would have required having some lyrics, and it's that ice cream cone, therefore making it pretty terrible. Like, that ice cream cone was his diss towards Gucci Mane, and it wasn't very good. But you know, all these people who saying that they 90s hip-hop heads and all of that shit, they want to throw soap on Waka Flocka, when that's fucking stupid, because you look back at the 90s, and some of the biggest acts out there was who? 3-6 Mafia. Wasn't no lyrics there. They gave you the same feeling that Waka Flocka is trying to give people. Then there was Master P and No Limit. Same shit. But overall, man, there was two tracks on here that actually gave me the feeling that you come to Waka Flocka to feel, you did. And it was that 7 days a week and not rainy days, man. But besides that, you really ain't getting too much of nothing. Like, I sit there, listen to this mixtape, it felt like I'm listening to music at work. You know, if they playing music at your job, they ain't gonna play too much of shit. So you just sitting there listening to it just to get your fucking work done, just to get to the end of the fucking day. That's kind of how the boatload of this mixtape felt. So overall, man, I got to say it's a 4 out of 10. I really wouldn't recommend it. But anyway, on to today's article from downloadpaz.com. And today's article is about cutting corners, in which this is something you can never fucking do. See, too many rappers want to cut corners on the rise to fucking fame. Pretty much go out and try to buy subscribers, try to make things look like they're going by a lot faster, being a lot bigger than what they really are. And the reason why you don't do this is because you lose track of what you actually are. If you buy 100,000 views, 2,000 subscribers and shit, you cannot accurately determine which one of those people are going to actually fuck with you. Also, in aspects of the grind, man, like some people want to take weekends off. Some people don't put in a full day's work every fucking day. This shit adds up and costs you in the long run, dude. If you're going to do the shit, do it right. When the time comes for you to succeed, it'll happen faster if you don't cut corners and do it the way it was supposed to be done. If you do, you slow yourself down.
Some of the realest shit I ever.